Spider-Man, the Spectacular Spider-Man animated series, one of the best cartoons ever made. Now, of course, we have the Spectacular Spider-Man. Very nice red and blue costume of Peter Parker, aka Spider-Man. Of course, this is not a new figure. I bought this figure loose, so it is a bit old. Are fading away, specifically like the eyes. They're not white, they're like yellowing-ish. Of course, plastic tend to get old, so you can see there's like stains, marks, scratches off the whip, the spider symbol. And the order these characters first appear. So first up is the Vulture, Adrian Toomes, an old man wearing some sort of high-tech suit to fly around. The Vulture, who worked under Oscorp and was fired by Norman Osborn. Clip-ons, it's like right there, so it doesn't like is in the second episode of the Spectacular Spider-Man. I like his electricity running all over his head. It's pretty interesting and pretty cool, as it should be. Again, this figure was not new, I didn't model new. It came with one accessory, which in my opinion, that accessory is important. Say otherwise. eyes and everything. Behind here and clean his belt. Look at that. This utility belt right there. No, I'm just kidding. It's just a regular belt with like pockets. The symbol of the tricorn. And of course down here are his legs. This shocker is so beautiful. Like out of all the villains, Shocker's my favorite villain, in case you haven't noticed, but he's one of my favorite villains. Wow, look at him, ready for some action. Let's pose this guy. Like he's about to shoot out. Let's buy a beam or something. Shocker, Montana. It's not Herman Schultz who plays the character in this show. It's Montana, the leader of the Enforcers. I kind of wish they had all the other members of the Enforcers so I could have them like, display with the Shocker, of course. But unfortunately, we didn't, so. Oh well. It is what it is, I guess. Of course, this figure that came was an accessory, and that is, of course, his little blast effect. Whoa. Let's put that in the camera. Now we're gonna blast you away with this effect. That is crazy. So I came with this little shockwave effect. And I'm glad it came with it because I wanted this complete set. And basically, for this figure, we were put it like in this arm right here, because for some reason it doesn't connect here, because maybe it's a fist being clumped up, but we would put it here, and it says like, shoots out his blast. I can't even put him in position just because he's like too heavy and too big, so oops. So like, I can't even like have him positioned like this, unless he's like this or something. Shocker. One of my favorite villains of all time. Alright, moving on to the next villain. Okay, now we have Flint Marko the Sandman. Oh boy, this guy is something else. So another figure I bought loose. Look at the details of the sand. I don't like this. Those tiny holes, it gives me like tribal phobia. It gives me the chills just by looking at that. I don't know about you guys, but I don't like that. But you know, we get a nice detailed sand, and we have like a little sand right here and a little switch. The details of this hand, you can of course rotate it around. Oops. You could rotate this hand around. But look at Flint Marko. Accurate to what he would look like in the cartoon. His belt and of course his sand legs. And yeah, the detailing is on point. His pants is like pockets behind here. But yeah, it's a pretty cool figure, if you ask me. So basically with this switch you would like go this. And that's what he will do. And it's even more awkward because you have to lift it instead of pushing it down. So, I don't know what you'll exactly be doing, but he's just shaking his hand. Kind of a pointless gimmick, if you ask me. I mean, this figure should have came as an accessory. It came as like a hammer, but it never came. So, I just got it the way it is. But still, a good figure, though. Sandman, another favorite villain. Chet Flint Marko. And moving on to my last figure, unfortunately, because I don't have the other figures, as I said before. So moving on to my last figure. Last but not least, the Green Goblin. The Green Goblin, aka Norman Osborn. We first thought that it was his son, Harry Osborn. Look at this cool looking this figure also came with is, of course, his glider. Look at this beautiful glider. It looks really nice. Very nice indeed. The turbo engine, which is kind of weird. Why is it purple? It should have been like reddish. Something like this. It's awkward position, but it does the job. It gets the job done, you know. So just like that, and of course this pumpkin bomb. Only let's see if I can. Nope, don't want to hold that one. Oops. Don't want to hold it. So it's for some reason it's one of the bomb. Okay, never mind, I got it. So there he is, holding this bomb, flying around like a crazy maniac. And just like that, he's holding the bomb. That is crazy. The Green Goblin's glider. It's just really hard for this figure though. So he's just flying around. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Now, as a bonus, let me put this guy away. I do have the other Green Goblin that I bought a long time ago. A brand new spectacular Spider-Man Green Goblin. Let me put it sideways in case you want to see it sideways. But yeah, brand new. So now I have. See them. I'll put them right there. guys enjoy this video. I'll